In this video, we're going to trace the flow of electricity from this pole transformer over into the house behind me. As you can see at the top of the transformer, we have one connection from hot to the bushing, and then on the side of the transformer, we have two hots and one neutral. The three cables run over here to the other pole, where they branch off into several houses. One of those branches goes down the pole, underground, and up through the conduit here under the electricity meter. The three cables from the pole come up through this piece of conduit and into the electricity meter. This little piece of conduit right here, just next to the meter, carries the ground rod. Ground rod is basically a piece of copper that's just buried down in the ground. This is what it looks like before it's put into the ground. This bare piece of copper up at the top is what runs through the small piece of conduit. Right here, inside the meter, neutral is bonded to the earth ground. There's also another piece of conduit just behind this meter that leads inside to the breaker box. Let's go inside and take a look. We're inside now, and we're going to see how the electricity flows out to individual branch circuits through this box. Before I take the cover plate off, though, I just wanted to point out that this particular box is very nicely labeled, so it's clear which particular circuit breaker goes with which circuit. I've already loosened up these screws ahead of time, so it should be relatively easy to get this plate off. There's a piece of conduit right there that leads to the meter outside provided by the utility company. And there are three cables entering the house through that conduit. Two black wires and one white wire. The two black wires are hot and the white wire is neutral. The black wires are 180 degrees out of phase with one another. Let's measure the voltages between all of these cables. If I measure the RMS voltage between the two black wires, I see that it's 246 volts RMS. Nominally, it's 240 volts, which is typical for a split phase system. Let's measure the voltage difference between the middle hot and the white color here at the right. I'm measuring 122 volts RMS. Nominally, that's 120 volts. Let's try it for the left hot. 121 volts RMS for the left hot. We have the main circuit breaker here for the house, and if you look just below the main circuit breaker, you can see two bus bars extending out here from the bottom. Those are bonded to two copper plates which run behind the branch circuit breakers over here. They're staggered so that it's not the case that all of these circuit breakers are attached, for example, to one phase and all the circuit breakers here are attached to the other. They're staggered so that if you put two breakers side by side, one of the breakers will get one phase and the breaker right above it will get the other phase. The advantage of that is by putting two circuit breakers side by side, you can get 240 volts in a two-pole breaker like this. We can see that this two-pole breaker here is labeled range, and that gets 240 volts. We can also see that it has relatively thick wires coming out of the switch side, one black and one red, indicating that both of them are hot. Most of the other circuit breakers here are just one-pole circuit breakers. For all of these one-pole circuit breakers, the hot is attached to the back side of the circuit breaker, unlike the situation in continental Europe or in Singapore, where the hot wire goes directly into the breaker and then the switched hot comes out the other side. The switched side of the circuit breaker is over here on the right, so all of the cables running here on the right of the circuit breakers here and on the left side over there lead to the branch circuits. So they distribute electricity out through the house, and then when they come back, we have two cables from each branch, neutral and ground. In Singapore and continental Europe, there would be a neutral bar to gather all the neutrals and then a ground bar to gather all the earth cables together. But here in North America, they're all attached to a single bar. You can see sometimes white cables and also bare cables lead to that bar. So neutral and earth are really bonded together right here in the box. They lead out through this neutral wire outdoors, which ultimately attaches to a grounding rod down into the earth and also to the system neutral up on the pole. You might notice that we also have a small box here on the side of the breaker. This is for a doorbell, it's just a transformer. The primary side is down here at the bottom and the secondary side is up here at the top. If you look at the primary side, we have two wires going to it. One of those wires attached to the hot side of a breaker, and the other side on the primary is attached down here to the neutral bar. The secondary side of the transformer is attached to a cable. It's a 16 volts that leads to a doorbell. I hope that by viewing this video, you've learned something about the typical split phase circuit breaker box here in North America. We have a whole series of professionally filmed and edited videos in order to help students learn the fundamentals of electricity. If you like watching this particular video, then you might like to check out some of our others too.